And so, Benedict and Beatrice were left to consider this new information.
What fires in my ears? Can this be true?
This can be no trick. The conference is sadly bored. But on the truth of this hero, it seems pitiful. It seems their affections have been full bent.
Stand I condemned for pride and scorn so much?
Love me? Why must you acquit it?
Contempt, farewell, and maiden pride adieu. No glory lies behind the backs of such.
They say the lady is fair. 'Tis true, I can bear her witness, and virtuous. 'Tis so, I cannot prove them, and wise. But for loving me, by my troth, it was no addition to her wit, and nor great augment to her folly, for I am horribly in love with her.
And Benedict, love on. I will requite thee, taming my wild heart to thine loving hand. If thou dost love me, my kindness shall incite thee to bind up our loves in a holy band.
I may chance have some wit broken on me, because I have railed against marriage for so long. But doth not the appetite alter? A man enjoys the meat of his youth that he cannot endure in his age. Shall whips and sentences, these paper bullets of the brain, awe man into the career of his humor? No. The world must be people.
For others say thou dost deserve, and I believe it, better than reportingly.
And I said I shall die a bachelor. I did not believe I should live until I was married.
instead of a minion.
What's your idea? Big thug, you?
Well, I recently befriended a lady who looks just like Hero.
Just like Hero?
Except for the nose.
The nose.
And the eyebrow.
The eyebrow. Basically,
her entire face.
Wait, how is this helpful, Borachio?
Well, she looks just like Hero from High.
I see.
And if I'm reading the signs right, I think she might want to kiss me. What do you think would happen to Claudio's wedding if he saw his bride kiss a thug like me?
Thug indeed, Borachio. We must put this wild plan into action.
And so they went to put their vile plan into action.
Ah, my lady and my sister. If your leisure be served, I would have a word with you.
In private?
Claudio may hear, for what I have to say concerns him.
What's the matter?
Need your lordship to be married.
You know he does.
I know that, but he knows what I know.
If there be any impediment, I pray you discover it.
You may be confident. Let that not appear hereafter. It may be better, I think, as I will now manifest for my sister. hero. Leonato's hero. Every man's hero.
I was up there. I saw it with my own eyes. Oh! And maybe I would! Hero! How could you?
Not married her after this betrayal.
I guess my wedding is off, Al.
Fear not, Claudio. I will find Leonato. And you will not be made the fool.
My heart shall never heal.
Calling it off is the right thing to do, but I suppose the question is when you want to call it off.
As soon as possible.
You could do that. Save care of the embarrassment of calling off the wedding during the ceremony. Although, if my bride-to-be had dishonored you so, I would not spare her. I would not give her the courtesy she denied to me.
You're saying I should stop the wedding when I'm at the altar?
Yes. That would give me the chance to say how you feel about this whole thing, once and for all.
I have no talent for finding the right words at times of great emotion. That's why I can never consider myself a poet.
I can help you form your speech.
Your kindness has been unmatched this evening. Let's figure out the words later. Take any moment to collect myself. What have I to give you back? whose worth may match this rich and precious gift?
Nothing, unless you render her again.
Royalty has taught me many manners. So, good Leonato, take her back. Give not this rotten orange to your friend. She is but a sign and semblance to her honor, and I will not knit my soul to approve wanted.
Well, I'm definitely not going to cry.
What's going on?
Only last night did myself, Claudio, and my sister see your daughter Hero being overly affectionate with another man in your garden.
What? I wasn't in the garden last night. I don't even like gardening.
The wedding is off.
Claudio, what are you doing?
Responding to a great betrayal. Broke my heart.
What do you think you're doing to me? Cousin, come here, you look faint.
Oh, Hero! What a hero hadst thou been, if half thy outward graces had been put towards thy heart or thy thoughts or the counsel of thy heart. So farewell, most foul, most fair, farewell.
Hero!
Bid me do anything for thee.
Kill Claudio.
A real request?
You dare easier be friends with me than kill mine enemy?
Is Claudio thine enemy?
Is he not approved of the height? A villain that hath scorned, slandered, betrayed mine kinswoman. What, bear her in hand until they come take hands, and then with a public accusation. Uncovered slander in mitigated rancor. Oh, that I were a man, I would eat his heart in the marketplace. But I cannot be a man with wishing, so I will die a woman with grieving.
Tarry, good Beatrice. By this hand, I love thee.
Use it for my love in some other way than swearing it.
Find it in your soul, the Count Claudio hath wronged you?
Yea, as sure as I have thought your soul.
Enough, I am engaged. I will challenge you. I kiss your hand, so I leave you.
By this time, the rumor of Hero's death had reached the princess and Claudio.
I did not mean to cause her death.
So you've heard them? Funny how rumors travel so fast.
It was no rumor of Hero. We saw it before our eyes.
I think you did not. You have killed a sweet lady, and her death will fall heavily upon you. You will duel tomorrow morning.
What? Are you serious, friend?
If you do not, everyone in town shall know of your cowardice. Till then.
Are you serious, though?
It has been a most serious morning.
And our litter.
As I have told you a thousand times, I have told you once, Virgin, a master constable is nothing without a prisoner in his jail. Otherwise, what am I the master of?
Air.
No. You can't command air.
Oh no.
Trouble! Where? Tricky, tricky. Making us
behind
us for no
apparent
reason.
Let's go, Burgess!
Patience. Impose to me what penance your invention will lay upon my sin.
some good poems.
Indeed, he's not.
A hero would deserve something glorious.
And come you tomorrow to my house. Since you could not be my son, let you become my nephew. Yes, my brother has a daughter who is in hero's image. Wed her, and with it my revenge dies.
Your kindness is all from tears from my eyes. I do embrace your offer. Done to death by slanderous tongues, was the hero that here lies. Death and guardian of her wrongs gives her fame and never dies. So life died with shame, live in death in glorious fame. Hang thou there upon this tomb, praising her. I'm done.
Not bad. It's not Shakespeare, but. The next day, the new wedding was to take place.
I'm glad we did not have to duel after all, friend.
Me too. I would have hated having to kill you.
Are you ready to wed today?
Most humbly, sir.
This is she that I can give to you.
Sweet, I will be your husband if you wish it so.
Nothing
certainer. I can't even explain the ecstasy I feel right now. I'm overwhelmed with joy.
Only two words are necessary.
I do.
Then, unless anyone has any more to say.
Sailor, is that Beatrice under that veil?
I am that name. What is your will?
Do you not love
me? Why no? No more than reason.
Why then, your uncle? The princess and Claudio have been deceived. Could have sworn you loved me.
Do you not love me?
Troth, no. No more than reason.
Well then, my uncle and hero are indeed deceived, but they did swear you did.
They swear you would fall ill for me.
They swore you were well nigh dead for me.
Tis no matter. Then you do not love me.
No, truly, but in friendly recompense.
Surely you love the gentleman.
I'll be sworn that he does, for here, written in his own hand, fashioned from his own pure brain, is a halting sonnet, written to declare his love to Beatrice herself.
And here's another, written in my cousin's hand, stolen from her pocket, proclaiming her love unto Benedict.
Miracle. Here is our hands between our hearts. Come, I will have thee, but I take thee for pity.
I would not deny you, but upon this day I yield upon great persuasion, and partially so I may become a rich widow someday.
Peace. I will stop your mouth.
Aww, hooray for a happy ending!
And a wonderful party!
Come. We are all friends. Let us dance ere we are married, so that we may lighten our feet and our wives' heels.
Thank you. much ado about something.
That doesn't sound like very good people.
A confession. Two prisoners in one day. Somebody deserves a promotion. To jail.
Well, I guess now might be a time for a final joke. I'm gonna need your help, okay? Knock, knock.
Who's there?
The end of the play.
The end of the play. Ooh.
The end of the play. Who's still sticking around?